it's me again.
Hello, it's me again. And here's little Naomi. She kind of looks like a boy. Her hair, I made it long enough so we can put like a little sprout ponytail on top of her head. So I can dress her as both a boy and a girl and we can see what the mommy wants. But her hair's kind of fluffed out right now because I had her laying down. I need to put some pledge in her eyes. Let me see her focus. Little eyelashes. Those are really hard to root because she hardly has a waterline. And the white hair tends to be a little more, what do you call it? A little more coarse than regular mohair. I don't know why, because, you know, they just dye this stuff. But the one that I have is more coarse. I had to pick out a lot of coarse hairs. I'm going to see about getting some white alpaca for the eyelashes. It would be better for my little albino babies. So, that's her little head, and here's her little feeties. You guys remember when I painted her? It's been a little while. And her little arms. And I guess still have to cut the... Still gotta cut the... You see her veins? Probably not very good lighting right here. Here, let me see. I'm gonna turn on the light here so you guys can see better. Okay, there we go. That might be too much light, but now you guys can see her veins. Mm-hmm. Her little fingernails. She has very, very little, very white hands and white legs. So here's her, she has a back and a front belly plates, so I have to cut. It is female gendered, so she's gonna be a girl. Can't really make her a boy, I guess. Her belly plate's gendered, so I gotta cut these little thingies out of the sides, and I'm gonna get some thin elastic and kind of put these together so you can kind of pull it apart and put it on over her head, like kind of like a shirt in a way. That way it'll stay together. I will try anyway. So I have my oven. I'm going to show it to you guys. Okay, so here's my oven. These white boxes have the rings in them, and I just ordered two more, so I'll have enough rings to do my toddlers. So I put a blanket. I will put a blanket in the bottom. I want to run the oven by itself with this digital thermometer inside, and make sure that the temperature is right and stays steady. Because I know that some of these kind of ovens, they have problems with keeping their temperature. I like this because you can turn it off and on this way. So that's off and that's on. Oh, sorry. This is off, this is on. There we go. Sorry, I'm not used to holding the camera. According to the video that I watched on my piercings, you can lay a blanket over the top, over the side of the rings. Because see, these rings just sit on top of here. See, they're these rings, so they just sit. You can stack them, and then you put the cooking part on the top. All this metal over here is useless to me, so I don't know. I'm not sure what to do with it. I'm just using the one that's down there. So I have this blanket out. I'm thinking about maybe using this blanket for the bottom or a towel. I have a bunch of towels that I can use too. So we'll do a little experiment. I'll do it on camera. We'll plug it in and we'll see if it maintains temperature. And also I have to figure out, because it's got one of these kind of deals on it, you know. So we'll have to see. If we're supposed to be at 130, so that would be 130 right there. So we'll have to see if it's really, truly 130. And it has a little timer on it, but I won't go by that. I'll go by this. Also, I'm going to watch very closely because I'm going to be afraid. Be afraid of melting my doll kits. So,
Here's my little Nala again. She's so cute. Oh, I'm going to get these guys put together. I got a bunch of cute clothes for them. I just got a little outfit for Nyla. This is a cute little outfit. It's a little shirt and a little kind of knit. I'm showing you. I'm not showing you anything. I'm not good at holding the camera, you guys. So it says, hello, little one. It's a little nice cotton shirt. And then it's a little knit pair of bloomers on the that go on the bottom. So I got that for her. I thought that would look cute on her against her darker skin. Okay, so I also got a bunch of stuff that I'm hoping will fit. I got this little shirt and some little shorts and a bunch of little outfits. I forgot the most important part. The oven is not staying in here. I have a mask and everything, but it's going outside, so I'm going to get a little cart with wheels and some little, it's got some little shelves underneath, so that'll go on the top, and then my rings and everything will go in the shelves underneath, and it's going to go outside in my garage, which is like right out there. It's on over there. It's going to, that way I can pull it. Hey, the light's back. That way I can pull it in and out of my garage. So, or my kids can push it in, like, if the weather changes suddenly. So, it's not staying in here. So, this is the last time you'll see it in here. So, we'll do the test. And we'll see if it maintains its temperature. And then we'll put it on the cart and put it outside. And my varnish should be here soon. So, my varnish in mediums. So, nope, I got Naomi's arms and legs over here. I was just cutting the parts off of her belly plate and her tummy plate. And now she's sitting over here. Her eyes are drying and her pacifier magnet's in. And that's going to be her pacifier. Okay, so I'll be back. I'm back. It's hot. It's not really hot outside. It's just hot in here. Because I can't really open my windows or my cats will get out. I got these little baby-proof things, little straps to put on the window to keep my cats from being able to get out. Also, we don't have screens, so it's not a thing in France. I don't know why. Crazy, I know. They're getting them now, but not, you know, it's hard to find them. I tell you guys. Timber's little lippy pooge. You look so cute. I almost don't want to put any more. Maybe I'll put a flesh coat on him, see how he looks. Because he's got a pretty yellow kit, so maybe we shouldn't put any more yellow on. I don't know. I'll decide later. He's so cute. I have a box, so let's open the box. And then I'll explain that. We're going to have to do the oven test this weekend because I can't reach. There's a plug down there and there's one down here and I have a multi-plug, but that cord's like really short. So I'm going to have to figure that out. I found a cart to push my oven in and out of the garage. It would be funny when the people come to deliver. They're cooking a baby. Hi! Just cooking dolls. It's okay. Okay, be right back. Okay, so I haven't opened a box with you guys in a long time because I keep opening them so you can just hide my address. This is from Boutique Reborn, which is a French Reborn site. They sell like some bountiful baby kits and not a lot of limited kits, but maybe like older kids, Ping Lao kids. I've been wanting this baby, and I saw somebody else, a friend of mine did it, so yeah. Put that in. I got a couple more brushes because, you know, I love to play with paint the hair brushes. I don't know why. I have tons of them. I just keep buying more. Okay, I'm going to use these limbs. I'm probably going to go ahead and paint them so I can see how they look.
I'm going to use these limbs as practice for, because they're three-fourths limbs, even though they're kind of cute and chubby. I almost like them. Anyway, this is Lisa by Linda Shear. So, she doesn't have a COA. She's got her name on the back. It says L. Shear, Lisa. So, she's an older doll kit, but she's so cute. So, I'm either going to find some more limbs for her, or, I really like her limbs, though. They're cute, but I don't like three-fourths limbs. I don't know. I'll have to think about it, because they're really cute and chubby. I don't know. What do you guys think? How much do you dislike three-fourths limbs? Because I could find her some full limbs somewhere. I just like that they're chubby. I don't know what to do now. Oh, well, I'll think about it. But I love her little face. So, there's that. I've got too many boxes in here, so we're cleaning up this weekend again. Got to do a clean. I got to clean this up too. It's just, it's hard for me to do things. I get so tired so easily. I need to pick up after myself maybe. That might help. Got some glue over here because I was doing pacifiers. I need to put the moleskin over this pacifier. It's hard to find a pacifier that fits her right. See, this one still doesn't sit right. And I don't know what I'm going to do. But anyway, she's very cute. I can't wait to put her and Naomi together. They're going to be so cute. They look so, like, you're just like going to fall in love with them when you put clothes on them. You get them all put together, you know, they look kind of weird with the little, with their, what do you call it? I forgot about this magnet. With their little bodies, you know. And then you put the clothes on them, and they just look like babies. So that's my favorite part is putting. So I don't know if I ever showed you guys how I put my magnets in. I use this plastic spoon, and I put the magnet in there. It's got glue all over it. I should try to get some of that off. And I put the magnet in, and she is, or no, it was Naomi, had a hard, I almost didn't get the spoon in, because she's got a smaller, opening to her head. So I put that in, I put the pacifier on here, and the magnet just, boop. I have this stuff, this little thing. I got it from, it's a little magnet stick. I got it from McPherson's. When I want to put a magnet inside a baby with an open mouth, see? The magnets in there. So this is what I use. So, and I have a really strong magnet inside. So I'm thinking, let's try this one. I wonder if we could do a modified one on her too. Let's try. I'm going to cut this off. I don't know if I can or not. Also, this is kind of silicone, so not really a good thing to put into vinyl. Yeah, I don't think so. Maybe if I could cut the sides off. See, all these parts of reborning is just so much fun. Trying to find the right pacifier, trying to find the right way to put it in the baby's mouth. Trying to find the right magnet. That's why I have a stock of a lot of different things. My husband's always like, but you already have magnets. Yeah, but I don't have these size magnets. Silly man. I have to cut a little bit more off of here. I don't know if she can take a modified pacifier because I'm afraid that her mouth is too small and it's going to rub too much. No, I don't think this is a good idea. Especially with the silicone. I mean, it stays in there, but I don't want it rubbing on her mouth. Nah, I'm worried about that.
don't want it to mess up her paint. Because silicone can kind of make vinyl, like, kind of mushy. I don't know if the pacifiers really do that, but it's possible. I have silicone beads, and I, at first I thought, you know, it's cute because it makes the, you can put them in the bum, in the rear, and make them a little squishy. But, let me get this out of here. But, I don't like them. It makes me nervous that they're going to go again. There's some, you know, something's going to, the bag will somehow break open and they'll go against the legs. And so I got these, rubber, they're like little rubber beads. I got them from a German doll store. And those, I like those way better. I put those in my, my Vito. I don't know if this is going to work or not because this, these are so thin that they're not even really strong. This seems to fit better on her though. Maybe. Yeah, maybe that one fits better on her. That looks kind of cute. I like this one though. But, yeah, maybe that one sits better. I don't know. If I can get this flat one to stick, try this one again. If this one doesn't work, then I'll try the other one. Because I like this one better. Okay, is that... stop it. Okay, is this... Which way does this go? That way, right? I can't tell which... You gotta put it the right way, or, you know, there's the male and female. Okay. That goes on the pacifier. Let's put some glue down. I need to get the other thing to glue out because this one is almost gone. So, I promise we'll paint. And I saw the thing that Quimby is going to be released soon, so that's exciting. I should paint her and Maeve together.
Hello. Okay. I didn't get my room cleaned up. I didn't get a chance to check the oven yet, but we'll do that. Let me show you the babies. I got the babies together. So, 1 minute. Okay. Got my light on so you guys can see better. Here's Nyla. So... she's got the sheep hair, again, makes it curly. It's kind of mushed in the back because I've had her laying down. There's her foot. Her leg. Another foot. Her little knee. And here's with the little curled up hand. Oh, I mean, this one's the one with the thumb sticking out. The other one's more curled. There we go. And here's the other one. This one's the one with the scratches on it. You can see her vein on there. She's got veins on her hands. Okay, so she's got acrylic eyes. They're, you can see they look better because I put more pledge on them. So they look less, they're still light, but they look better with the pledge on them. I actually brushed the pledge on because it kept just like, I think there's no gap. I don't know where that pledge was going to. So I just brushed it on. Usually I just put the drops in because I have it in a dropper bottle. She's, she's over 5 pounds, so she's got a good weight. She's got squishy pellets in her tushy, so feels like kind of like a real bum. Oh, this got her in her cute little outfit, and she's floppy and she moves. So I'm going to put her down real quick. So, because there we go. She's heavy. Heavy when you hold her with one arm. Nope, sorry, babies. Let me shove you out of the way. Naomi. She has a sprout on her head right now. Yeah, and a close-up of Naomi. Because she is an albino baby. Her hair's kind of longish, but I like it anyway. I did cut a little bit more off the back, but I don't want to cut too much of it. I like it the way it is. So here is one of her hands. And she has more translucent skin, so you can see more of her veining. All right, she's more heavy. She's over 7 pounds. Well, close to 7 pounds. She's 7 pounds. I don't remember now. We tried to make her. You see her little nails. Her nails on this side. I'll show you guys her ears. I didn't show you Nyla's ears, did I? Get her hair out of the way. Okay, here's her little feeties. I need to do a lot of blushing on her hands and feet because I want her to be as light as possible. There's her toes. There you go. Good. And her leg. And there's the outside of her leg. You can see her veins. There's her other leg, her more straight leg. Her foot. And her nails and her other side of her leg. So, she's a little bit bigger baby. Ping Lao doesn't give her babies like her smaller babies much of a neck. And they have those tiny little flanges, you know. Everything moves still. And her leg and her head. We put her head a little bit tighter because it popped off the first time. So it still moves. See, it's just a little bit more snug because those little flanges, they're like really thin and tiny. And like I said, they don't have much of a neck, but she kind of looks cute that way. I put this little shirt on top of her. She has a onesie on underneath and she's got these little shorts. I have a couple outfits for her, but I really wish I had a dress for her. So maybe I'll find a dress for her. Anyway, she has a back and front belly plate. I'm going to get some thin, oh, her hair smells so good. I just washed her hair and conditioned it. It smells really good. I'm going to get some thin elastic so you could like put her belly plates like over her head or like from her legs up, you know, so you don't mess up her pretty little face. Can you guys see her lashes? She got tiny little white lashes. I had a hard time getting her lashes right because this hair is kind of coarse. I mean, it's not coarse. It's really soft. But it's, you know, for lashes. What works best for lashes is alpaca. I usually use alpaca for lashes. But I don't have any white alpaca. I need to get some. So, I'm going to be busy doing photo shoots. So, I'm going to probably put Nyla up first for sale. And since she's a sold out kit, I'm going to price her a little bit higher than I was thinking. Probably around the $600. And then I'll get to Miss Naomi up for sale. I'm rooting Ruben, but he's kind of spoken for already. And then I'm going to go ahead and root Zoe, who's also spoken for. And unless, Zoe's mommy wants me to do Ayana first. That's fine with me. I've been dying to root Ayana. And then actually Missy comes after Ayana, but I'm rooting faster. I'm rooting a little bit thinner, more thicker on top. She's kind of thick. I went a little crazy. I usually do. But it's still thin, too. So, she's so cute. I love this little face. Okay, so, I think I'm going to go ahead and end this video because it's already been long enough, and I'll get this one up. And I will, like I said, I'll get Nala up for sale, get some pictures of her. I need to move my oven because it's in the way of my photo studio over there. It's in my photo studio. You are heavy, child. Ugh. There we go. Here. Look at the people. Look at the people with your little sprout. Her hair lays down really nice, too, so I just put it up because I think it's adorable. I love sprouts on top of baby's heads. That's why I rooted her hair longer. So, I'll come back and we'll do some more painting. I decided I'm going to get my criers out next time. Since I've got so many toddlers I need to root, I'm going to get my little criers out. So, you guys, you want to do Maria, you know, by Sabrina, her garden, the one, you know, the screaming one. I'm doing her. So either we can do Little Cry by, is it Phil? I can't think of, you know, it's L-I-L, Cry, Little Cry. I can show you guys the kits if you want me to. Or, Harriet. Is that Harriet? Yeah. By, A.K. Kitagawa. So, I don't know if I want to do all three. Because I'm already going to have these two waiting for hair. I need to start practicing painting, don't I? I got too many things to do. I got to start my, I also need to start my vampire baby. Might have some fun news about him later. Okay, so if you guys like what I'm doing, please like and subscribe and create an authentic doll kit like Naomi by Ping Lao. And get some paint and hair and eyes and all that good stuff. And paint a reborn because it's fun. Okay, bye.